The vision to transform a museum that opened in 1941 involves raising $100 million, engaging a world-renowned architect, and is sparked by a love of art and community. It's a recreation, even a reinvention. What better endorsement could there be than from the director of the world-famous Whitney Museum in New York, who sees magic here?
The way a building can be aspirational for, not only for the museum, but for a community. And, you know, a museum isn't a building. A museum is the art that is in it and the people it engages. But to have the vision of creating a building that could bring those elements together is extraordinary.
If you know the old Norton, you won't recognize it. From the breathtaking new street side entrance to the reimagining of the galleries, the beautiful new theater, new outdoor spaces, huge sculpture garden, it can rival any museum anywhere.
Now, this whole project really isn't about just renovating an 80-year-old museum. It's about reinventing it, making it a centerpiece of the arts world in South Florida. And then again, everything old is new again. The original concept of the Norton in 1941 was small one-story buildings built on a courtyard. They've restored that. But it is more spectacular than anyone could have imagined.
That word is easily repeated. It's about vision and people who believed in it, says museum trustee and board member Gil Maurer.
This is a day beyond belief, Todd. Something that we've almost gone 10 years in building and raising the game of people here in the Palm Beaches. You know, a lot of people thought we couldn't do this. And here it is. Spectacular.
Architect Lord Norman Foster, who's created Queen Elizabeth's Great Court and the Hearst Tower in New York, doesn't hide the emotion of this moment.
It's just a tremendous buzz.
And while grand openings are great, the Norton Museum's future looks far greater.
This is the possibility of being one of the great museums in America.